Welcome back, my moon babies, and thank you so much for being here today. If you're new here, welcome. Today I decided I'm going to do something based on body positivity and self-elevation. So today I'm going to be giving you 10 tips or ways to love your body. If that interests you, please keep watching. Okay, so for tip number one, this one is one of my all-time favorites. I always recommend this to everyone, whether you like it or not, or whether you've done it before. It doesn't matter because I feel like there's a clear space in your mind for everyone when it comes to this sort of thing. But I believe that everyone should meditate. Meditating is really good for your body. Definitely one of my number one go-tos when it comes to self-love and loving your body, because when you meditate, you put your mind in a state of bliss. I mean, you're literally being present with yourself. You're acknowledging your body, your breath, everything like that. And I think that that's really good for our health in general, whether it be mental or physical. But yes, number one is to meditate. Tip number two would be to surround yourself with people that love you for you, that love your body for the way it is, and people that pretty much lift you positively. Like, if you are around anyone, and I mean anyone, whether it be family members, friends, anyone, if you're around a person who's constantly tearing you down or criticizing the way you look, what you wear, anything, get rid of those people, because that's something that's in the back of your subconscious, basically. It's like a little voice in the back of your head constantly telling you, like, oh, this isn't good enough. Oh, that doesn't look good enough. Oh, you shouldn't wear that. Your body doesn't look good in that. You know, you don't need that kind of negativity. Get rid of those people, ditch them, move on. You'll be so much happier. Basically listening to yourself instead of that little voice in the back of your head from whoever it may be telling you that you're not good enough. And that leaves room to tell yourself more and more every day that you are good enough. Number three for me would have to be mindful movement. And when I say this, it's pretty much similar to the whole meditation thing, except for me, my specific practice that I like to do is yoga when it comes to mindful movement. A lot of people like different things, kickboxing, you know, going to the gym, things like that, which is... the gym is something that I want to start incorporating into my routine more, but for now, yoga is my thing. I love yoga. Mindful movement, or anything that's really good for your body in general, is just definitely a plus. Like, that's a way to love your body. If you want to take care of your body, I personally suggest yoga, because yoga, just like meditation, is something that you can be mindful and present in, something that you can, you know, listen to your breath and actually acknowledge little things that you wouldn't notice before. And so I definitely recommend yoga. Yoga is amazing for not just the body, but the mind. Yoga helps you align with yourself. If you haven't yet, try yoga. And if that doesn't work for you, if it doesn't resonate with you, try something that makes your body feel great. And when you are at your best potential like that, you know, mentally, you're gonna start loving yourself more. You're going to start feeling more comfortable in your own skin. And that's the goal here. Number four. For number four, I want to say a good reward. When I say good reward, I say that every now and then, let yourself indulge. Everyone needs to indulge at least one day out of the week. It's how you keep your mind happy, you know what I mean? If you want to eat a piece of chocolate, eat a piece of chocolate. I love vegan chocolate when I'm feeling sad or feeling down, and there's nothing wrong with that, especially when you're not doing it constantly. It's best to have balance. You want to give yourself lots of love and lots of good things, but every now and then, eat that piece of chocolate. You know, go girl, make yourself happy. Number five, you have to find your own zen space. A place that when your body is feeling drained or exhausted, or you just feel like you've absorbed maybe too much negative energy that day and you just need a place to restore or reset your mind, you need a zen space. Like the room I'm in now, this is my yoga room, this is my filming room, this is the room that I keep my altar in and things like that. This is my zen space. Like, this is the place I go to when I need to escape from everyone and when I feel like I need to breathe and relax and just, you know, connect with source. I truly believe having a zen space is a form of loving your body, because your body will thank you so much more when you have your own sacred space to get away from everyone and let your body recharge. Number six, ask for help if you need it. There's never ever anything wrong with asking for help. Talk to someone who can help you feel like the best you. You know, maybe you could go to a therapist and they'll tell you, like, you know, the things in your mind. Maybe you're not obese. Maybe you're not underweight. Maybe that's just something you're telling yourself. And going to people like that and help, getting help in the long run can really help you mentally stabilize yourself and realize that you are good enough the way you are. Number seven, slow down. And when I say this, It's not just for people who binge and things like that, or who don't eat at all. When I say slow down, I'm talking both mentally and physically. Start to consume things like plant-based foods that will really help your mind and body. And I'm not saying this to push veganism on anyone. I'm talking plant-based. If you really feel that you can't be vegan or vegetarian or anything like that, at least try a plant-based lifestyle. This is more of like a double-sided thing because I'm telling you, you know, slow down, but also I'm talking more on a plant-based diet. When it comes to slowing down, I mean slow down on things that harm your body. So I definitely say slow down on the bad things and, you know, increase in the good things. Number 8. This is a pretty simple one. I'm not telling you to avoid the mirror, but I'm saying cut down on looking at yourself. When you're constantly in the mirror every day, you're giving yourself plenty of time to criticize and, you know, just self-hate, and you don't want that. And I'm definitely a guilty victim of this, you know, thing. I literally, when I'm in the bathroom, I can't, like, when I see myself in the mirror, I stop and I literally will sit there for like 10 minutes just improving things that I think are wrong or things that I just don't think are how I want them to be, and that's not the way it should be. I feel like we should really start to consider how much we stare at ourselves and criticize ourselves. You know, if you're looking in the mirror less, that's less time that you have to sit and criticize yourself. Number 9. This is one of my all-time biggest ones. Do not blame your body. It's not your body's fault. The body you have is the body you're meant to be in. The body you have is the body you need to love. Now, I don't really like to identify with my body because these bodies aren't actually us, you know what I mean? You shouldn't identify with this body, but you should love this body while you have the chance, you know what I mean? In this lifetime, you want to take care and love the body you have. Don't blame the body. Don't beat up your body, you know what I mean? Don't blame your body. Learn to love yourself, you know? Your body is something sacred. All right, so I hope this video helps at least someone out there. I really think that people should start loving themselves more. It's something that I plan on working on this 2019. I still wanted to say Happy New Year to you guys. I didn't get the chance to do that, but it's really great to be able to just be in a new year, a clean slate, fresh energy. The moment 12 o'clock hit, I felt that energy shift immediately. This year is just gonna be intense, you guys, and I'm super stoked about it. Anyways, as I always say, spread that lunar love and peace and love, man.